Hey everyone, Devin here from American Aquarium. Hope you're doing well. Welcome to the new season. I want to talk about something that is not a new thing in the hobby, but seems to be something that most people are not aware of that it's even an option in the hobby. So if we're talking about some of the best filtration for our freshwater and saltwater tanks, hands down it's going to be the Fluidized sand filter. Why do I say this? A sand filter is going to take a reaction chamber, it's going to plumb water in, down through a down tube, and then come back up into the base and turn sand that is continually bouncing off of itself, off of the other sand particles. There's so much surface area within a sand filter because of how much sand surface each grain allows bacteria to form to it. And then it's continually cleaning itself because the sand is turning, bouncing off each other, wearing off the old bacteria, getting new bacteria, and creating some of the best filtration for a biological filter in aquarium. These filters are meant for nitrification of your nitrogen cycle, so it's going to be taking care of ammonia and nitrites. But also one of the benefits of the taller model sand reactor is that in the top part of the chamber, since there's so much distance, there's actually denitrification that happens. So we actually get some nitrate control as well, which is really awesome. These filters by far will outcompete any canister that's on the market. I would even say for most applications, it's better than a sump, or even paired with the sump, that makes it even better. Running them off of their own standalone pump is another good option. These things are meant to be a more of a hanging on the back, so they sit right on the edge of the aquarium. If you have a pump in the aquarium with, say, like some pre-filtration sponge, man, you've got a really good filter. We can take a look. The sand filter, at least that we back and we promote here in the hobby, it's got three different sizes for different sizes of aquarium. Amount of filtrations is small, medium, large. Best is to go with as large as you can, but you can run a whole entire aquarium system off of just one of these filters. It's best to have redundancy, but man, you could filter a whole tank off of just a sand filter. One of the added bonuses of having a reaction chamber such as these is now we can also control other things such as like nitrate, phosphate by just adding something like the MP bioplastics. This is a polymer. Man, is it effective. It is one of the most effective, which is in, say, 4 or 5 days. You could take high nitrate and bring it down really low, really quick. It's a very effective way to manage nitrates, which is perfect for freshwater, even better for saltwater. Another thing that's cool that some people use these filters for is using them for other media. While they're not designed to hold other media, you could use it as a temporary solution. So I know some people that have put biohome in here. That's not the proper way to use the reactor, but it can be done. I've also seen people use something like carbon. Say if there's an overdose issue, a medication issue, you got to remove some medicine. You can take your carbon, put it within your sand reactor, and all of a sudden you just got a really good carbon filter to remove any toxins very, very effectively, very, very fast. So this is an option that American Aquarium Products promotes within the hobby. Not because, hey, we're just like, we like this line of filters, we think they're good, but because we've had extensive use of sand filters over time, over decades of time in the industry. And we found that by far you're going to get the most filtration with the sand filter. We've even used sand filters to filter whole fish rooms filtration that nothing could beat. So highly, highly recommended taking a look and adding a sand filter into your setup if you're not already. Another awesome thing too for people that are considering high CO2 dosing, this is a filter system that does not wear away CO2. There's no real surface tension being broken. The water is being plumbed in and exited real gently. So for someone that's trying to concentrate on keeping CO2 in the aquarium, this is a real good option. So, and another really cool thing that's these filters offers, you can put different types of sand in there. So we can put a silica inert sand in there for fresh water, which is really just going to then help with bacteria growth. But for a saltwater tank, or say maybe a cichlid tank where we know we need calcium in there as well, we can use an oolitic sand. So this action of the sand bouncing off each other is wearing away and is actually buffering your calcium. It's not really adding to, but it's not taking away, it's helping maintain that calcium. So that's a very good benefit if you have the need for added calcium of the tank. So take a look at the sand filters if you haven't yet. If you haven't realized this is an option for filtration, hello, here it is. It's some of the best that's out there. Highly recommend maybe just take a small canister filter and use a medium-sized reactor, and all of a sudden you'll have better filtration than the largest FX6. Or just use it as a hang-on-the-back filter with a regular water pump in the aquarium, and you still can outperform many canister filters. So I just want to bring this to you guys' attention. Had a lot of questions about what is a sand filter, but here it is, guys. It's common. It's been common for a long time. So we've had experience with other brands in the industry, but we go ahead and back the TMC brand because it is a more professional quality build. There are some known published issues with the sand filter, but let me tell you, based off of hundreds of applications and working with many customers who purchase this, if you set it up correctly and make sure that you slowly let water into the system, most of the time you're not going to have an issue, the known published issues about a sand filter. Hey, once you figure it out, you have the best filter, period, hands down, for a new type of water. So I'll show you the reaction chamber here real quick. You got a long reaction chamber with a base. You got the downspout tube that's going to be your intake. Water's going to be plumbed down through the intake and then come out. And in here, I'm going to give this a second for my camera to adjust. You'll see a spiral pattern with holes that plumbs water and spirals it through a rock media or a ceramic media into sand, and then keeps the sand fluidizing with this real long motion of turning the water from top to bottom, up and down, fluidizing your sand. Hope that was something exciting for you guys to take a look at. A lot of questions, a lot of people don't know about them, so that's why I figured I'd bring it to your attention. If you have any questions, of course, ask and take a look at the sand filters. Take a look how we recommend them. Take a look at the user applications that we have all on our website. Take a look at our extra articles that we link to that shows how others are using this in hobby and industry. And of course, like always, please like, subscribe, share. We really appreciate your guys' help, support, getting this type of information out to the hobby. We really appreciate that you guys look to us as a resource to be able to help you with your product needs. All right, I will talk to you next time.